गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू रे शिक्षण संस्थाज ऑनलाइन लर्निंग प्रोग्राम। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न लेसन नंबर 13, सुल्तान गियासुद्दीन इन द काजीज कोर्ट। हंड्रेड्स ऑफ इयर्स एगो इन द ईस्टर्न प्रोविंस ऑफ बेंगाल, सुल्तान गियासुद्दीन आजम शाह रूल्ड द लैंड। हिज कैपिटल वॉज सोनारगांव। सुल्तान गियासुद्दीन वॉज ए गुड रूलर। He ruled wisely and well. He respected men of learning. He had a deep regard for law. Now see what happened here hundreds of years ago in place that is in Bengal, especially in the eastern province of Bengal. Province means territory. There lived a sultan and his name was Sultan Ghiyasuddin Azam Shah. And he ruled that land, and the capital of that place was Sonargaon. Sultan Ghiyasuddin was a good and wise man. He was a good ruler, and he respected men of learning. Men of learning means well-educated men, and he would love to follow the laws. Now next paragraph. One day, while the Sultan was practicing with his bow and arrows, he accidentally wounded the only son of a poor widow. The wounded boy did not survive. Weeping and wailing, the poor widow went to the Qazi and told him what had happened. Now, when the Sultan was practicing with his bow and arrows, what happened? By mistake, means accidentally, without any intention, he wounded the boy, and the boy was only son of a poor widow. Widow means a woman whose husband is dead. That poor widow had no one except her son, and by mistake, Sultan hurt her son. He wounded her son, and the boy did not survive, means he lost his life. And then the poor widow started weeping and wailing. Wailing means crying and sobbing long and loudly. And then the poor widow went to Qazi and told him what had happened. Now next paragraph. The Qazi was an honest and upright man. He sent an officer to summon the Sultan to his court. When the officer reached the palace, the guard stopped him and inquired about his business. When they learned that he had come to serve a summons on the Sultan, they were shocked. They refused to let him go inside the palace. Now see here, the Qazi heard everything what the poor widow told him. And Qazi was an honest and upright man. So he sent a summons to Sultan with his officer. Summon means to order someone to come before the court. And when the officer reached to Sultan's palace, the guard stopped him and asked him, "Why did you come here? What's the business?" They inquired. They asked about his business. Business means what work he had come with. Now, the officer told them that he had come to give a summons on the Sultan. Summons means a written notice asking a person to come to the court, and on hearing this, the guards were shocked and they did not allow him to go inside the palace. Now see the next paragraph. The officer was now in a fix. The guards did not allow him to enter the palace, but he knew that he could not return without serving the summons. The Qazi would not take him back. He had to find a way of reaching the Sultan somehow. What could he do? He thought and thought. Now here, the officer was not allowed to go inside the palace by the guards, and now he was in a fix. In a fix means he is in a difficult situation, and he did not know what to do, because if he did not give the summons to the Sultan, he would not be able to stand in front of Qazi. Now he had to think about the plan. How will I give the summons to Sultan? So he thought and thought, what could he do? Next paragraph. At last he began to sound the azan, the call for the prayer, loudly just outside the palace. It was not yet time for the prayer. When the Sultan heard the loud, untimely call, he was greatly surprised. He ordered that the man giving the call should be brought before him immediately. Now what happened here? The officer thought and he came up with a plan. He started the sound of azan. What is azan? Azan is a call for prayer, and he is standing outside the palace, and it was not the time for prayer. And so the Sultan heard the loud sound of azan. He said, it's not the time for azan, and who is making this loud noise? And he was surprised and ordered his guards to bring this person, whoever he is, immediately inside. His soldiers rushed out of the palace gates, caught the officer and took him to the Sultan within moments. When the officer knelt before the Sultan, he was trembling with fear, but he mustered all his courage and explained why he had given the call for azan. Then, with shaking hands, he gave the summons to the Sultan. Sultan Ghiyasuddin took it without making any comment. He read the summons and told the officer to go back to the Qazi. He announced that he would appear in the Qazi's court the next day. Here in this paragraph, we learn that the officer would get a chance to go inside the palace because Sultan ordered his guards to bring him inside. So he got a wonderful opportunity to enter inside the palace and give the summons to Sultan. Now he started getting scared because all the soldiers came to take him inside, and the officer knelt before the Sultan. Here knelt means it is the past participle of kneel, and kneel means supporting yourself on your knees. Now here officer knelt before the Sultan. He was trembling with fear, means shivering with fear, and he mustered with courage. Mustered means gathered his courage, and then he explained why did he make the call for azan, though it was not the time for prayer. And with shaking hands, he gave the summons to Sultan. And you know that what is mean by summons. Summons is a written notice to Sultan to be present in court. Now the Sultan took this summons in his hand without making any comment. Without making any comment means he did not say anything. He read the summons and told the officer to go back to Qazi, and he also told him that he would come in Qazi's court next day. Now here are some words from the lesson. Read these new words and write in your notebook. In this way, today we have learnt the some part of this chapter, and next time we will see the remaining part of this chapter. Thank you. Stay home. Stay safe.